In a world where we've got satellites that can almost zoom in and watch an ant pee on a leaf, you'd think our society pretty much knows everything. Even with all of our fancy technology, there are still a few ciphers and codes keeping cryptologists, trust us, that's a word, absolutely stumped. Some of them come from way back in the 18th century. Even with the addition of advanced technology, we still haven't managed to crack these ciphers. Number 10. Dorabella Cipher. They say authors possess exceptional minds, the ability to take a blank page and turn it into something intriguing, an art form that pulls at the emotions. At the end of the 18th century, author Edward Elgar sent an encrypted message to his young sweetheart. The problem is, this mastermind managed to disguise his message so well she couldn't even read it. Elgar was fascinated with the idea of encrypted messages. He even cracked a supposedly uncrackable code that was published in the famous Pal magazine. Over the years, people have noted the recurrence of the same scribbled symbols, or cipherbet, that made up the Dorabella cipher in Elgar's music compositions and personal notebooks. Everybody has a theory, but no one has provided a concrete solution. Number 9. D'Agapayev Cipher. A few decades later, Alexander D'Agapayev wrote a book on cryptography. The year 1939 was pre-computerized encryption, and it is believed his unbreakable code was completely hand-drafted. The mind-boggling phenomena is more difficult to solve than other tablespun codes of the pre-modern world. D'Agapayev may have been too good at what he did. His most famous codebook was so difficult he couldn't even solve it himself. Cryptanalysis took his cipherbet and, as usual, assigned the numbers to letters. Unfortunately, that turned up a big pile of nothing. All they had was a bunch of doubled and tripled letters. His book, Codes and Ciphers, printed by Oxford Press, wasn't any help either. For some reason, later editions decided to leave out his famous cipher. People probably got tired of getting so close to a solution and then realizing they were still so far away. Number 8. Indus Script. Between 2600 to 1800 BC, the Indus civilization flourished. Also known as the mature Harappan civilization, the Indus people have been written in history as the most advanced urban culture of their time. The complexities of the Indus people weren't discovered until generations later. The first attempts at deciphering the Indus script were made long before the civilization was rediscovered. Many historians have taken a turn at tackling these symbolic messages. Some believe the writing of the Indus people served as the foundation of hieroglyphics in ancient Egypt. Teams from Russia and Finland each came to the conclusion that the script was of Druid origin. Regardless of where it came from, the 400-sign pictograph alphabet has great minds stumped all over the world. It is believed that the population of the Indus people reached over 1 million. With that many people to govern, it's safe to say they needed to come up with some sort of language. At the civilization's end, they're apparently so selfish they didn't leave a cheat sheet for the rest of us. It must have been on a need-to-know basis, and apparently we didn't need to know. Number 7. Chinese Gold Bar Ciphers. General Wang of Shanghai, China, received 7 gold bars somewhere around 1933. The design resembled metal certificates that people get when making deposits in US banks. The biggest difference was the mysterious pictures and writings that were found on the bars. They were engraved with script writing, Chinese writing, and Latin cryptograms. Pushing 90 years later, we still haven't figured it out. Totaling 1.8 kilograms, the Chinese writing is believed to detail a transaction of over $300 million. The true reason behind General Wang receiving such an elaborate gift from a secret admirer would be a lot easier to determine if we knew what in the world the gold bars said. Able to read them or not, we looked at the engravings and were pretty sure there were some big bucks involved in the transaction. You don't have to be a cryptologist to see that big golden smile plastered on what we think is General Wang's face. He's probably laughing straight to the bank. Number 6. Zodiac Killer. While we credit the Eastern Hemisphere for the introduction of the Zodiac and horoscopes, we're sure they want no part of one of the US's most infamous serial killers. Not only was he responsible for multiple deaths, the psychotic Zodiac Killer made sure he also got credit for them. In 1939, he sent letters to 3 California newspapers boasting over recent murders. Attached to each was 1/3 of an encrypted cipher that he demanded be printed on the front pages of each newspaper. After doing all the usual detective things and coming up empty, the police force had no choice but to play his game. Claiming over 37 victims during his rampage in the 1960s and 70s, a few of the Zodiac Killer's messages were decoded. However, the vast majority are still unbroken. The FBI even went so far as to release the rest of the messages to the public in the hopes that some upstanding citizen would be able to decipher them. Number 5. Linear A. This is kind of a two-part mystery. Historians have managed to identify a relationship between the Phaistos disk and Linear A script, but they're yet to decode the message. The Phaistos disk was found in 1908 with swirling clay characters printed on both sides. Experts have pointed out 45 characters, but don't know what they mean yet. In addition, they discovered a number of tablets with two different styles of writing. One style was Linear A, and the other was Linear B. Linear A was determined to be much older than the latter method. It was singled out to an origin in the island of Crete. A British rookie named Michael Ventris put all of these experts to shame when he broke the code for Linear B. The secondary form may have been cracked, but Linear A still has the experts banging their heads against their desks. Number 4. Proto-Elamite. Outranking the Persian Empire, the Elamites are the world's oldest evidence of civilized living. Even in 3300 BC, it was necessary to develop a written language to be able to communicate with your neighbor. In 8th century BCE, the Elamites used shaped clay tokens to represent different goods or services. They even developed clay wallets and IDs to mark who owned the money and how much they had. This proves to be the earliest evidence of a numerical system. Near 2900 BC, their language advanced to a completely new method. It is assumed that the unbreakable Proto-Elamite language was some form of accounting system. It is still something that stumps modern cryptologists today. Some progress, if you want to call it that, has been made, with historians finding similarities between the Proto-Elamite and Proto-Cuneiform styles of writing. Unfortunately, at the approach of the 5th century BCE, Proto-Elamite began to fade away. All that's left are 1,600 clay tablets that nobody can read. Number 3. Tamanshud. As shown with the Zodiac Killer, murderers like to get their rocks off in more ways than one. The body of an unidentified Australian man washed up on the shore of Adelaide Beach over 65 years ago. The media christened him the Somerton Man. Figuring out who he was is one of the least perplexing parts of this mystery. Random stuff in his pockets led the Australian police to the local train station. There they found his suitcase that was full of normal man things. The lack of leads and a coroner's report that showed that he was entirely healthy before he died had people throwing around the idea of him being poisoned. It took 2 whole months and a random re-examination for officials to find a small pocket that was previously overlooked. In it was a small rolled piece of paper that read Tamanshud. After revealing the latest find, a guy went to the police and said he'd found a copy of the exact same book in the back of his car the night the Somerton Man was murdered. Under ultraviolet light, the mystery magnified with an unreadable 5-line code. The jumbled letters didn't strike any chords. For years, officials and various volunteers have attempted to crack the cipher. Professor Derek Abbott and his students have committed to cracking the code since March 2009. However, others have given up. New claims say the victim was a Cold War spy who was poisoned by enemies. It's a lot easier to sweep something under the rug than to admit the bitter taste of defeat. Number 2. McCormick's Cipher. Ricky McCormick's body was tossed in a Missouri field on June 30, 1999. 2 years after his death, 2 notes in his pockets were the only clues detectives had to work with. Even with the efforts of the Cryptanalysis and Racketeering Recording Unit, CRRU, and American Cryptology Association, the notes have yet to be decoded. The victim's encrypted mastermind has the CRRU so stumped that the McCormick cipher ranks in as number 3 on the CRRU's list of brainbusters. Over 30 lines of coded information include numbers, dashes, letters, and parentheses. With so much information, the possible ciphers are virtually endless. McCormick's family says he wrote in ciphers all throughout his childhood, but none of them knew what the notes meant. Although he was only missing for a couple of days, McCormick's body quickly decomposed. This made deciphering his notes the cornerstone of solving his murder. FBI codebreakers normally bust through ciphers in a couple of hours, but somehow McCormick, a man who could barely write his own name, gave the professionals a run for their money. Number 1. Bacon Cipher. The Voynich Manuscript is a small illustrated composition written in cipher. Rediscovered in a Jesuit school in 1912, the contents were renamed the Bacon Cipher because history traces the origin of its contents back to an Englishman by the name of Roger Bacon. Some historians discredit Bacon's involvement due to the inclusion of various alphabets not used during his time. Conversely, its illustrations support claims of Bacon's contribution. He was well known for his interest in composing an elixir of life, among other mystical teachings. Similar topics were mentioned within the Voynich manuscript. So was Bacon privy to the realm of the unknown? Well, we'll leave that up for someone else to debate, but one thing that goes undisputed is we don't know what the heck it means. Many attempts at breaking the secret code have been made. Some claimed it was rearranged Greek shorthand, while others believed the key lies in the illustrations. Every theory proved to be ineffective. Those who still attest the cipher to Bacon are amazed by the information he had access to, things that weren't discovered by the masses until years after his death. So I hope you found that video interesting. If you did, smash that like button below. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the notification bell. Also, why not check out my podcast? It's called The Brain Food Show. If you search Brain Food, one word, in Apple Podcasts or wherever you get your podcasts, you are gonna find it. And as always, thank you for watching.